Dr. Lipy Gupta and I'm a dermatologist at Max Saket and I have my clinic at Green Park, Delhi. We'll be discussing about a common problem of facial pigmentation today. As we all see commonly that there are both men and women who are affected with hyperpigmentation involving different parts of the face, and this can become a general cause of low self-esteem amongst these patients. Whenever a patient suffers from facial pigmentation, the patient tries to hide it and camouflage it using different cosmetics because it is something which is socially not acceptable, and many a times people point out towards this kind of pigmentation. It gives a very unhealthy and an unsightly appearance to the face. We'll be discussing about the most common causes and how we can manage them. The most common causes for facial pigmentation are freckles, melasma, solar lentigines, and other rare causes of pigmentation include lichen planus, photodermatitis, and contact allergies. The reasons why facial pigmentation may develop may be a hormonal issue. People who suffer from polycystic ovarian diseases or who are on oral contraceptives or progesterone containing medications may develop facial melanosis. Besides this, it can also happen in thyroid disorders and other metabolic conditions. Excess sun exposure and lack of sunscreen usage also triggers freckles and other sunspots, which may develop more on the cheeks and the sun exposed areas. Whenever we have a patient who comes for us with facial pigmentation, we always assess the patient regarding all these factors. And the prime advice which we give to these patients is to develop the habit of using sunscreen properly. Now, sunscreen are both physical as well as chemical agents, which when applied on the skin may help reduce the amount of UV induced sun damage, which causes increased melanin and pigment synthesis. Sunscreens are these days available in different bases, which may suit an oily as well as a dry skin. And depending on what skin type you have, you may consult your dermatologist for an appropriate sunscreen for you. A sunscreen is effective only for up to 3 to 4 hours of application, and after this, a reapplication is advised because it becomes ineffective after 3 to 4 hours of usage. Besides this, there is a wide array of skin pigmentation and skin lightening medications which work by decreasing pigment synthesis in the skin layer. These medications are topical medications which contain kojic acid, arabutin, azelaic acid, and other non-hydroquinone based formulations which work to decrease pigment synthesis in the skin. These formulations may work for your pigmentation, but the problem arises when either this formulation is not working or these formulations are increasing the sensitivity of your skin. In these cases, we now have other treatments available which may help you to reduce pigmentation. These are broadly lasers and chemical peels. The laser which is used to reduce facial pigmentation is known as a Q-switched NDAG laser, which is a quasi-continuous laser wavelength. This laser works by the principle of selective photothermolysis. The laser energy is absorbed by the melanocytes, which are the pigment producing cells, as a result of which these melanocytes are destroyed and are removed from the area where the pigmentation is increasing. This principle of laser works for almost all kinds of skin pigmentation. Over a period of time and after multiple sessions have been done, you can observe a decrease in the pigmentation, and in many a times we see a very good clearance rate and a good patient satisfaction when this laser has been used. This laser doesn't have any side effects of any skin burn. The laser energy which is delivered to the skin is properly calculated so that the risk of laser induced skin damage or skin burn is not there. Over a period of time, a visible improvement in the pigmentation can be observed, and the results with this laser are more long lasting. We do not have a permanent cure for many of the pigmentations which happen on the facial area, especially when they are hormonally related. In combination to lasers, we also use a wide range of chemical peels which contain glycolic acid, kojic acid, lactic acid, azelaic acid, and many a times we are also using long duration peels like retinol based peels, which work by exfoliating the skin layers as well as decreasing pigment synthesis. One of the drawbacks with the retinol based chemical peels is that they cause a massive exfoliation of skin, which increases the skin sensitivity for a few days and at the same time makes it little more prone to sun damage. So whenever we are going for these long duration peels, it is important that a good sun protection is followed after the peels have been performed. These treatments are generally performed at an intervals of 2 to 4 weeks depending on which kind of peel is used, and the results are satisfactory after 1 or 2 sessions. In many resistant cases of pigmentation, we use a combination of chemical peels and lasers to give the maximum benefit to the patient. Oral medications which also help in reducing skin pigmentation, which contain oral tranexamic acid, oral glutathione and other antioxidants, are also added sometimes to help in reducing facial melanosis. This is how a Q-switched NDI laser is performed. After the face has been cleaned properly and all the makeup which has been removed on the face, the laser is performed specifically on the target areas and a single pass is performed on the full face. The patient is comfortable when the laser is performed. After the procedure is complete, there is a mild redness which settles within 1 to 2 hours after the procedure is completed. After the laser is completed, a facial mask is applied on the face so that it acts as a soothing agent for the patient. This is kept for 5 minutes and then after this, the face is cleaned and a sunscreen is applied on the patient's face before the patient leaves the clinic. Overall, a dermatologist today has a wide array of armamentarium which we can use judiciously and customize it according to the patient's need and requirement, so that we are able to maintain a flawless skin and we are able to treat and reduce pigmentation in many difficult to treat dermatoses. So whenever you find anyone suffering from facial pigmentation, it is very important to consult a doctor and not treat it yourself with over-the-counter medications which are available at the pharmacy. A proper guidance is required when using these medications, and these treatments should be performed only by trained personnel, because many a times both chemical peels, lasers and even your skin lightening creams can have side effects. Thank you. All of these treatments are available with us at our clinic at Green Park and at Max Hospital. So you can contact us for any queries. Thank you.